Come on in and have some fun.
Come on.
So just come in and learn with us with the mouse in the house.
Woo-hoo!
With Lucia and Vinny and Jessica and Dino.
Yeah.
So come on, young scientists, come join the mouse in the house.
Uh-huh.
Hi, guys. My name is Max. Welcome to my lab. Which ball would you expect to float? A big one or a small one? Well, today we're going to make floating steel balls. You will need two steel balls, one big one and one small one, but both weighing the same, and some water in a large bowl. Let's begin the experiment. Weigh the balls to make sure that they both weigh the same. Place the big steel ball in the tank filled with water. Let's look at what's going to happen. Wow! It's floating! Now, put the small ball into the water. As you can see, the small ball sinks right to the bottom. Now it's your turn! Place the balls on the scale and make sure that they both weigh the same. Put the big steel ball into the water and watch it float. Now repeat this experiment with the smaller ball. Incredible! You would think that the bigger ball would sink, but not this time.
Why did one sink and one float?
The bigger ball is less dense than the surrounding water, which makes it float. And the smaller ball is more dense, causing it to sink.
What other objects can we use?
Well, you can use any objects, really. See what objects you can find in your home and have fun with floating and sinking objects. Remember to ask your parents first. All aboard my space pod! We're off to the ocean to see how boats and enormous ships float on the water. Ships are made of steel, so why do they float? A ship has a large volume of air trapped in it, and therefore has a lower density than the surrounding water that it sits in. So it floats. See you back at my lab! Today's green tip is... Be careful not to litter on parks and roads because it's not very good for the environment. Well, that was another great experiment! Bon voyage!